I will wait. And now, excellent connection. Excellent. Green excellent, it says in the new YouTube Live control panel. Does that mean I'm live on YouTube? I'm not seeing anything listed. Let's go to the live tab. No. Still nothing. There we go. And I hear it, and I see it. And now I'm my own viewer. Wow, it's 3:35. All right, well, good. Hey, I got an alert about my own. Got my own alert. Okay, well. Got my own alert. My own alert to watch my own stream. How about that? Very good. I'm back because I did my little update video and it made me want to come back again. Hey everyone, I'm Dan, first person looter, and I'm back playing Far Cry 5 for the second time, but the first time on my Xbox. Completed the story and got all collectibles and the challenges on the PlayStation. Did not platinum though, and I'm not going to achievement them on this either, but I played more and I got more trophies while I was off stream again. It's always easier when I'm not on stream, which makes it seem fishy, I know, but I guess just when I'm not streaming, there's just a little bit less stress of knowing that someone can be watching me fail, I guess. I don't know. Oh, but don't let that deter you from watching. Like, oh, no, I'm going to stress him out. It's fine. So, one of the trophies that I'm going for now is to get all four fishing rods. And in order to do that, you need to come see. Dun, 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 dun. You need to see, where the heck is it? Yes, you need to go to Dylan's Masturbate Shop. Go to Dylan's Masturbate Shop, which is here in Jacob's Region. Okay? Maybe I should call this Fishin' for Faith. And I'm still kind of doing faith stuff. So there it is, Dylan's Masturbate Shop. And you'll meet someone there named, her? It's her, but they're not showing you her name. Karen or something? You'll meet her and you'll go fishing with her on a little simple fishy thing. And then when you do that, it says, hey, you want to get some hard fish? And in order to get the hard fish, you got to go to two places, and one of them is here. This one will light up on your map when you do it, so we got to go to this fishy fish. And the other fishy fish is, I'm already forgetting it, some around there, around here. It's another fishy fish. This one? Yes, that one, I think. That's the other one I'm gonna need to get. But I just picked this one first, so here we are. When we landed here, there was a bunch of bad guys. And I started fishing, and yeah, it is hard because they, it seems easy. I see them coming to it. They're coming over to it. Once I get them almost, right when I get them real close to the edge, they just snap the, they just snap it. Get it, because you're real close. Got it, all right. What? Okay, and he went away. That didn't happen when I wasn't streaming. I think so. Yeah, I mean, yesterday I kind of knew that it was not going to be a good situation, but for now, I'm telling you, this is why I record. My schedule, my life is just a scattered mess all the time. There's always things going on. I'm always being pulled in multiple directions. In some contexts, that's great. And what is that flashing blue line over there? What was that? Oh, right where the water meets the land, there was like a weird aqua blue line. Oh, it's kind of flickering. Series S graphics, I guess. No worries. Listen, I got the Series S on eBay for one. Oh yeah, everyone's going to it. Got it. For $189 or $199. And it came with the 1 terabyte Seagate. See, they get so close and then all of a sudden become super difficult. Then they don't want to behave. And I see that it's orange and I let go. I let go of the real line. I let it go green again. But then it'll just snap. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Blur-Ras 4 Loco. Oh, really? I don't actually drink. I did drink a little bit. I was never a huge drinker, so it wasn't too much of an issue to stop drinking. I just had a bad experience. Nothing like illegal happened or anything. Nobody got killed or anything. There was no drunk driving or anything, but I just had an emotional night and I just did not want to drink after that. Because it just took me back to that mindset. And then after a while of doing that, I just ended up just not really feeling like drinking at all anyway. But I don't ever tell people not to drink. I'm not. Come on, you damn fish. Oh crap, a wolverine, someone yelled back there. That's one of the many things I love about this game. I'm holding L, come on. I like that my line goes through this, maybe I should step back a little bit. Oh, goes through the wood thing that's in there. Come on. Is that a glitch? Like, go. But I've heard things about 4 Loko. When I was drinking, it was always like, I don't like the, that's the other thing. I don't like the taste of beer or wine. I had wine when I was too much of it when I was 13. Because I was raised. This, yeah, something's wrong here. This can't be right. Like, it's just, I was raised in a Jewish household, and before my bar mitzvah, I went to live with the Hasidic Jews in Brooklyn. Something's wrong. You never had one after that? Well, good. Yeah, see, at least you can learn your lesson. It's a valuable lesson. Look at this. My wire goes through. Oh, here we go. Now it's starting to. Maybe I need to be closer to the water. Maybe I was doing the wrong thing. But anyway, yes, they said, my synagogue said you can't say no to these Hasidic Jews. Like, it's not right. You gotta follow the customs. I'm like, oh God, all right, what does that mean? And then they were telling me I had to drink all this wine. And it made me sick. Throwing up at night, it was terrible. Oh, yeah, now it snaps, sure. Maybe I need to go, like, over here or something. Do I even have the best? I don't even. Because there's. I have two different fishing rods. Is this the good one? I don't know. Thought you died. From the hangover? The hangover was so bad she thought you died? That's another thing about it. I don't want to wake up with a headache. I don't want to wake up nauseous. I don't want to wake up with a hangover. Another reason I don't really mind not drinking. Also not liking the flavor of wine or beer. And all I really had was like whiskey sours, vodka sours. But I would keep adding more and more of the sour mix. There you go. Freaking finally. What an absolute unmitigated disaster. Catch base. Catch base. Do I have... I've got the new OBS. I can plug in my music app, right? I can just play drum and bass. My favorite genre of music ever. Of all time. Which I've opened up some of my streams with. Wait, what? 1 point perk awarded for what? What'd I do? What happened? Who cares? I got a perk point. That's all that matters. but I'm glad you didn't actually die. That's the bottom line. Sorry, again, my thoughts are scattered when I'm playing and talking and listening and reading. So you're married. Your username, the kid. I just assumed you were a younger person. But don't ever assume. Because it makes an ass out of you and me. I don't know why I would make an ass out of you. Yeah, drum bass. It's like a electronic subgenre. It used to be called jungle. I guess before that it was breakbeat. It kind of originated with taking some of the breakbeat records and the DJs would just play these 33 RPM records at 45 RPM. They were experimenting with that. There's like the famous samples like the Amen Break. There's a great video online about the history of the Amen Break. And they play all the different samples that used it. And it's from the Winstons called Amen Brother. So that's why it's called the Amen Break. It's a lot of those songs in the 50s would just have a moment where it was just like a mini drum solo, you know, just a da 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 da, and then back into the music. And they would take that da 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 and sample cut just that part, speed it up, and they chop it up. So it's da 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 da. They could do all sorts of crazy stuff. And yeah, it came from jungle, was sort of the origins of England, the street scene, the underground scene in England. A lot of Jamaicans were coming into the area, and it was jungle. There's a lot of those Amen breaks and a lot of specific type of bass sound and specific types of samples, but it kept evolving and evolving, and it branched out and the music started evolving. And so they started to name this new style drum and bass, though jungle, still that type of sounding music is still made. So they still call that jungle. It's like rock music. Now there's like heavy metal. Heavy metal is from rock and roll. And there's still rock and roll being made today, but... Oh. Oh, Billy the Kid, JDX the Kid. Got it. Yes. Yeah, drum and bass, I grew up listening to all sorts of stuff, electronic music, rock music. My dad played all the classic stuff, as well as all sorts of super weird, bizarre stuff. So I went from listening to all the super popular stuff, Beatles, Rolling Stones, The Who, Cream, then getting a little weirder, Captain Beefheart, Frank Zappa, then to even weirder, Zymox, or they were called the Clan of Zymox. Android Sisters. I listened to the Doctor Who theme. We had a little record that had just the theme on it. But then also Sesame Street records. Free to Be You and Me. I loved Free to Be You and Me. And these were all on records on my little Fisher Price record player. So I listened to all sorts of stuff. And then in high school... No, Faith, I'm not ready for you yet. That's what she said. I want a fish. Not your fish, Faith. Yeah, I listened to, like, I was in, like, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. There was a lot of grunge. I was obsessed with Nevermind, Nirvana's Nevermind. I was obsessed with a band called Butt Trumpet, who actually had a song on the radio. I couldn't believe it, on our local radio station. I got into Weezer when the Blue Album came out. Big pop, popular rock and roll stuff. I don't know how I totally started getting into electronic music, but one of my friends in my high school gave me a cassette tape that had electronic music on it. And I didn't understand. I had no concept of DJing in this. Oh, that was easy. See? Why couldn't the other one been that easy? Yeah, I'm not ready for you, Faith. Calm the hell down. Whoa, whoa! Hey. Shoot that big bass.
If you think you're ready to catch the Admiral, I'm down at the Claggett Boathouse.
I'm sorry. Holy moly, where did you come from? Love the chaos of this game. They gave me a cassette tape with electronic music, but yeah, I didn't understand DJing in terms of, like, yeah, I understood radio DJs. I understood, like, I saw DJs playing at, like, bar mitzvahs. I guess they were mixing music, but the concept of mixing songs wasn't really in my mind. So when I got a cassette tape of this electronic music, the whole one side of the tape sounded like it was one long song. I really thought that I was listening. Where did you come from? But you're green. Look at that. You're a good boy. Oh, shit. Oh, God almighty. Yeah, I thought I was just listening to one giant song. Didn't realize it was a bunch of songs mixed together. And I would discover that they were a bunch of songs mixed together because they took me to a club that played this kind of music that was on the cassette. And, like, it was a small club, but it had tons of lights packed in there, a lot of mirrors, smoke machines, speakers everywhere. Even though it was small, they surrounded you with all of this stuff. And there was the DJ booth. I'm like, let me see what's going on. And I'm seeing the record going. I'm like, all right, so this is the song that's playing. They put on another record on the other turntable. Music is still going. All of a sudden, the record that was playing all by itself is being taken off of the turntable. The other record's going, but I never heard the song change. I was like, wait, what? So what's happening? I didn't realize that they had mixed seamlessly into the next song. I couldn't tell the differences. I was like, wait, what? That was the first change. Like, wait, what is going on here? How are they doing this with sound? It blew me away. Like, well, what even are these instruments? Mechanical instruments. I understood what a record player was, but what the hell was this thing in the middle? And then I went upstairs to the third floor, and that's where the drum and bass room was, and that is what really changed my life. Oh my God, the drum and bass room. I was like, okay, what is this music? It changed me forever, and I just kept listening to it, and they had a radio show that I discovered because another person at my high school said, oh yeah, I also listen to that genre, drum and bass. There's a station out of New Jersey, WPIB Princeton. WPRB? How am I getting it wrong? Princeton, New Jersey, and they had Bassquake was the show, and oh my God, I listened to it forever. Oh yes. And I love hip-hop. I love the late 90s hip-hop, I guess, because that's when I grew up around it. Kendrick Lamar, and more recent, Muddy Waters, Kingdom Hears. Oh, I don't, JPEG Mafia. I don't know them. Red Veil, oh, I don't know them. Like, my artists that I notice that are, I guess, oldies stuff now, because now I hear it in the NFL. When I'm watching NFL advertisements, they're playing M.O.P.'s Annie Up. It's crazy. But M.O.P., Mobb Deep, Mos Def, a lot of artists that start with M. KRS-One, Onyx. I was playing Onyx for my girlfriend the other day, because I just started rapping it. She's like, what? What? I'm just one stinky, kinky, slim, not slinky, fiddle with your clitoris, pop your pussy with my pinky. He's like, excuse me? Like, what? That's Onyx. I'm Clean Jack the Black Vagina Finder. What's wrong with that? Can I not be? This is a free country. Experimental rap. Is this sort of like MF Doom sort of? That sort of thing. I don't know if MF Doom is experimental, but the fact that, you know, he wore a mask and everything was certainly a different style. There's also, oh God, who's the guy that had, I don't know if he was like, I think he truly was like a special needs guy. He did a Rock and Roll McDonald's. I'm forgetting his name. He wasn't a rapper, but I saw him live in New York. That was, the room was packed. I was kind of sitting on a windowsill to watch him. Rock and Roll McDonald's. What the heck is his name? I'm Googling it. Wesley Willis, yeah. That's right. Okay, well that's awesome. You're telling me about that's all this new stuff. I'm gonna have to check it out. Cause I listen to so much drum and bass that That's really all my Apple Music suggests to me now. I always go to the, oh, that's not helpful at all. The Discovery Station. You can barely see it. What if I bring the light down? The Discovery Station. Why don't you focus? Come on now. Oh yeah, because I turned the focus off. That's right. And everything's drum and bass. Look at that. First thing, drum and bass. Oh, you can't see that. I mean, this is one kind. That's the other beautiful thing about drum and bass. There's heavy, crunchy stuff. There's dark stuff. There's light, happy, beautiful, super synthy, a lot of female vocals, male vocals. Sometimes it's rapping, sometimes it's singing. This just happens to be a very specific sub-subgenre of drum and bass that's dark, crunchy, grungy. You know, so they, but, you know, there can be drum and bass. It sounds like that's beautiful. Almost sounds like the GTA 5 pause menu. Death Grips, I know. Death Grips, I know. Traditional rapper, but aesthetic. Okay, gotcha. Yeah. I mean, I love, like when I said, did I mention Common? I love Common because the song Used to Love Her. That's a great story. Mobb Deep, I said that I love Shook Ones. I guess it's not so much a story. I guess that's not so much a story. Immortal Technique. You know, everybody mentions Immortal Technique's Dance with the Devil, because that story is crazy, crazy dark, crazy disturbing. But then, like, all of his songs, like, I was introduced to Immortal Technique with a Third World, and that, I mean, that's more of a description thing, but still, like, you're still being described something very specific. The most unique voice. I will check it out. Thank you. Yeah, I will. I mean, I'll check all of those guys out. I like JPEG Mafia. I like that. That sounds so 21st century. Naming yourself after a file. A computer file. Wait, did I get my... I should do this first, because I was talking. Did I get my other... The guy here? Oh, shit. He's fucking dead. I wanted to see if I got the other... fishing rod. Let's go to any fishing place. I guess I can just go in any place with a gun. All right. Part one is good too. That is true. That black and white commercial video. I see my brain is going. It's like a black and white video. The Shook Ones part one. Also Maybach Music 1, 2, 3. I like the second Maybach Music. I love that opening. Help Skylar. I'm doing that. I guess I still got to do more then. I'm hitting the wrong buttons. So this is Skylar, right? I mean, these people have pictures. Why doesn't... The Judge Bear? Oh, I have to get all the judges. Oh. Love this game, but I'm not wild about how all these games have me killing animals. I don't like the killing of the animals. People are evil. Animals are not evil. We don't need to be killing them. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. So glad I mentioned MF Doom. Well, listen, I know some things. That's the other thing. My girlfriend is, she keeps saying, I'm always amazed that you like rap. Not that she doesn't like it. I mean, it's not her, it's not really her genre, but I mean, it's more that she's just surprised that someone like me likes rap. Because I'm always rapping along the song. She's like, what? She's surprised I know the lyrics to these songs. And her mom doesn't know rap either, but since they all watch the Eagles together, I'm always wanting to like point out what songs are playing. And this is Annie Up by M.O.P. This is the album version. They have a got a remix version with a bunch of other artists on it, like I think Redman's on it, right? Redman, or is that on the Simon Says? Yes, Simon Says by Farrah Monch. Farrah Monch is great. Nerdcore, I love it. Okay, very good. That's kind of cool, though. It's like when you discover an artist that you didn't know for a long time and they have all these albums, it's like this wealth of new stuff that you can check out all at once. It's like Netflix having a show and just that you just discover and all the episodes are out, it's all there to watch all at once. And then you don't get into the thing where, you know, a lot of people, if you discover a band when they first start, a lot of people always like, oh, I prefer their older stuff. I like them in their original thing. And it's probably because that was the first stuff you heard. That's what you like. It makes sense. It's fine. I get it. I liked Weezer's old stuff better than their new stuff. I liked Radiohead stuff better than their new stuff. I like some of their newer stuff. That's fine, but I think it's just because it's the first thing we listen to. But if you have all the music all at once, then it's all the first thing you heard. I hear someone growling. Uh-oh. Oh, you know what I can do? I can finally use this. Oh, and I can craft more. Very good. Automatically tag all the animals. Let's go. Are you that? Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh yeah, you got crazy red eyeballs. You're you. All right. Oh, and I can hire two people at the same time. So you go down and I'll have two ladies. Yes, yes, two ladies. Everybody help me. Shoot the ghost animal. Oh! Oh God, he's getting bigger now. That's what she said. Wait. Oh, whoops, I never turned the game sound back on. Whoops. Wait, what? Really? Why not?
I'm a good shot, in case you're wondering.
Come on, now that that's what she said, stuff is not playing through here? Really?
This mist just won't let up. It's everywhere.
Man, now my sampler isn't working. Dang it. Oh, that's interesting. Why he hated it? Well, I mean, some people just don't like things. You don't have to analyze why you don't like some things. There's things I don't like. I don't need to analyze it. I just accept it. What? You're two turkeys? Oh my God.
can do.
Dang it, I upgraded OBS and now another bad thing's happening. Why do I keep upgrading OBS? See, this is why if I was recording, I would have paused my recording and tried to fix it. And start recording again. Consume the thing that tags the animals, so where are you? Oh, there you are. The way up Dale? No? Who the hell's that, then? I didn't hire my dog. Oh. Oh, boy. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. It stings? That's not so bad then. These Dans. Right? Did you say Danny and now Dan Bull? How about that? Maybe I should be a rapper. Dan the man. Even my name would rhyme. Oh, that was a challenge too. Beautiful. Should not be flying while I'm on bliss drugs. There we go.
That was close.
Tsunami back. Okay. Tsunami back. Eventually I'm gonna be a reaction channel, my goodness. These live chats save, right? Like sometimes it seems like they don't save. I'll have to go back to my other streams. Because there have been somewhere, like, I had long chats, and then I went back and looked at the archive, and the chat wasn't there, and I was, that made me sad. I wanted to, like, reread what we had talked about, and also it makes it look like nobody talks to me. It seems like I'm faking it. You watch the stream, I'm like, oh, really? Is that so? That's happening? Oh, hey, what's up? How you doing? But then you're looking at the chat, and there's nothing. It's blank. Maybe I'm imagining all of this. Well, maybe because is opium copyrighted by Al-Qaeda. Uh-oh. Tsunami. I'm sure it doesn't. I'm sure it doesn't. What happened? But besides rap, like I'm loving Drain right now. Drain and Jill, I listened to, which is funny. Those two names. So, when I was. Rip. Rip his pecker off, Jesus. Yeah, trying to Google the show that I wanted to go to for Drain and Jill. I was getting a lot of plumbing services. Yeah, you are. I'm sorry. Okay. Well. Oh, Jesus. Where the hell am I? Where did I just fall down into? Scared me. A piece of rock I thought was the bear just sitting there. Oof. I guess the bear could come out of the cave, right? Oh, there you are. I'm sorry, little bear. Oh, you little badger. Honey badgers don't give a shit. Blissful. I like that. When you're full of bliss, it says blissful. Blissful. I like it. Excuse me. What is all this? A lot of little bears? There's a bunch of little bears. Whoops. I don't like killing animals. I just keep reminding myself that it's pixels on a screen. Make it worse by showing it dying in slow motion.
That could have been worse.
Yep.
Okay, so now do I get my... my fishing rod. Oh, was I doing the wrong thing this whole time? See, I don't know. Nostalgia. Oh. Oh my gosh, now that you describe Toonami, now that sounds familiar. I did not really watch too much anime, but I had friends who did, and now that sounds familiar.
If we hit a Peggy roadblock, be careful.
Let's get this show.
Was Toonami on Cartoon Network? Cartoon Network? I put the... That was a weird emphasis. Yeah, that sounds so familiar now. I have a few hours to get a trophy. I wish I had an easy trophy to get in this game and I got it before the day switched over. I think it switches every day at 12 p.m. Eastern time. It resets, and I got one of these trophies before it reset again. I got trophies, yeah, before it reset. Dang it. I was in a real helicopter once, and it had this glass bottom like this, and I sat in that seat right there, and we flew over the Grand Canyon. It was nuts. Because it looks like it was like this. It was seeing these trees, and they were moving pretty fast, but then once you get over over the cliff all of a sudden. Everything's so far down that it doesn't look like it's going fast anymore. It looks like we came to a stop and we're so high up. Oh my god, it was so crazy. And helicopters really do start flying so fast. We were hovering low on the ground, rushing over to the area that we were actually gonna get really high, and oh my god, it was... what an experience. Yes. Oh, sweet. I was watching like 90s gory, all the craziest. Devilman Apocalypse. I watched Devilman Apocalypse where he rips off her boobs and eats them. I had a VHS tape back in the day for Yurt Sakadoji that I got at my little local rental store. Apparently, that's a series of movies. I didn't realize that, but I got one of the Yurt Sakadoji movies. That was a highlight of my almost barely teen years. Might have that VHS tape in my room somewhere here. I landed. Oh. I just polluted the water. Real freaking nice. Is that it, my deal? Little fishies. Excuse me, lady. Look, my wire goes right through you. How about that? Wait, that's what she said, I think? Oh, Spirited Away. That's a beautiful film. Didn't the guy that did Spirited Away, didn't he just have some new movie that had come out? So you go on, you can grab it. You're right near my... Yes, I saw it. I fished once in real life at camp. I didn't like it because I didn't want to hurt the fishies. I want to put them back. Well, that's not what I wanted. You can sell fishies for a good price at any shop. In Spanish class, when I was like in 7th grade, we were supposed to watch a Disney movie. And we had a substitute that day, and she pressed play, and it was freaking El Mariachi. That was what was in the VHS player. I don't know if it was an honest mistake or if someone was doing a prank, but she's like, she was looking for the movie and we couldn't find it. She's like, well, like we were into it. We're like, oh my god, this is so violent and crazy. And she's like, well, they're speaking Spanish and you guys are enjoying it, so what is this now? Oh. Wow, eight. I mean, I know, you do gotta eat, you do. The older I get, the more sensitive I am to animal suffering. I don't understand what it is, it's getting worse and worse. I used to eat meat. I still occasionally eat meat. When I work jobs on the weekend, sometimes it's the only thing that's available for me. Paddlefish, where are you? Does the game just decide, like, we're gonna make it be these other fish for 3 or 4 times, and then it becomes... Oh, that looks white! And then they just time it. No. Yeah, that's gotta be it. It looks like it's got a little paddle face. Yay! Yeah, I think that's what it is. The game just makes you capture 3 or 4 other fishies. Wow. I couldn't do it. I eat fish now. Still, I do eat fish. I know it's kind of, it's hypocritical. Though I feel bad when I'm doing it, but I just. And I eat meat at the job that I do, that I, when it's the only thing available, and I'm working like 14, 15 hour days. And it's somebody else's food, so I didn't pay for it, so I felt like I didn't perpetuate. I didn't add to the industry. Wait, did I get it? I didn't see what I won. I was terrified of guns as well, but I started going to my local gun range. I took a gun class, shooting class, and I got a lot more comfortable with it, and I was going there a lot, doing target practice. That was fun. Isn't it crazy how, I was saying this in another one of my videos, that in the Civil War, the two sides just lined up in horizontal lines facing each other and just shooting at each other. Like, they didn't hide, there was no, it was just standing in line, shooting at each other. And then there would be people from the town that would just sit. Like, if there's a line of people here and a line of people here, crowd would just sit here and just watch them. That's nuts. Oh, Jesus, God, you're right. You were way too close. What are you doing?
I think Faith has the marshal who came for Joe.
Dang it! I gotta go back to some more Skylar, I guess? Ugh. Okay, there you are, right there. All right. I can't fast travel? Come on. Ah.
Ma'am?
Hi, ma'am.
Yeah, well, regardless of where they're from, like, who thought that that's a good idea to just stand there? No one considered sneaking around. Was there anyone in any, on either side that was watching all of his friends and family and co-army people? His other soldiers, fellow soldiers. They didn't look at all these people in a line and say, hold on, I'm not doing that. I'm not just gonna stand there. Let me sneak around. Let me go behind. I'll go behind them. Or I'll be off to the side. I'll hide behind a tree. My team is over there. My team. You know, the north is there. The south is there. I'm on the north. So I'll just kind of, here's the south. I'll just sneak on over here. They're all shooting over there. I'll just come right on over here and pew, pew, pew them. I'll pew, pew, pew them from the side. Wait, where's the lady? Hello? Hello? Oh, I thought it was the civil... What was that? Oh shit. Oh. Oh my god, what, you look like Leatherface. What on earth? Oh, that's why. Mercy. Use a dead man. Dang it. Sampler isn't working. Whichever was the war that had people lined up, I don't know, maybe I do have it wrong. Oh my god, look at that. That was close. Oh, I'm nowhere near Skylar. Oh, that's why. This is... ugh. Oh, okay, this is a good version of the song.
Thank you, Jesus.
Man, don't dwell on that shit.
Okay, let's see if this works. Fuck.
That's what she said.
There we go. Oh yeah, that's right. Drummer. I mean, that can make sense though. You want to make sure that everyone is in sync and in line, and that we're all showing up together. We're not just all fractured. And you're love this song. This is the end credits music. And now you're gonna shoot at me while I'm trying to listen to it. You son of a bitch. Yeah, get him. Hope that song is still on when I. Turn the car back on. I listened to rap. See, I got a rap sample right here. I've had "Use a Dead Motherfucker Now" on my sampler for a long time. It's an album I grew up on, doggy style.
You, not
Let's
look.
Get this show on the road.
Wow, muskets from trees. So were muskets, because they're so long. Did it sort of act as a rifle? Were they able to... I mean, I guess they were if they were doing it. Able to accurately shoot from afar? Didn't like spread out all crazy like a shotgun? Shotgun, bang. What's up with that thing? I want to know. How does it hang? Straight up, wait up, hold up, Mr. Lover. Like Prince said, you're a sexy mother. Oh, well, I like it. Dude, listen, I like salt and pepper too, all right? All right, I like salt and pepper. I just started rapping. Give me a scoop, baby, take the ride in my coupe. Oh, yeah, I remember this. I remember this from last time.
Goddamn Peggy's came out of nowhere. I clocked one in the face and took off.
Unit. My hand. Now I can barely hold the importance of small units. Hey, listen, that's... I say that in bed sometimes. The importance of small units. Oh, I don't say that in bed. Of course not. I say the opposite of that. Freaking opposite. The unimportance of small... I could never be a soldier. I'd just be giggling every time they were talking about units. I don't care how angry the... drill sergeant yelled at me. And I've seen those, like, police... Oh, that's not a way to go. I've seen the police training videos where they just keep taking the little squeezy... chicken. Little squawky rubber chicken toy, and they just squeeze it in their faces to see if the police will laugh. And if they do, they gotta do push-ups. That's hilarious. Really? When I was first doing the Chuck Norris or whatever it's called, the stunt guy stuff, I was doing terrible. I don't know. It's
think of all the money we'll win.
The boat was moving on its own. I don't know. It kept moving forward even though I was pulling back. Yeah, I was doing terrible flying. I was doing terrible. Is that him right there? But then I did it this time, and I did a lot better. I hope not better. Oh God, get out of the water. The rifled barrels, how about that?
That could have been better.
Jesus, Grace.
I mean, I live in Pennsylvania, so I've had multiple classes from multiple schools take us to Williamsburg, and we saw all those things.
Used to be
a lot of great, interesting historical battle locations. Uh-oh, the bear's in the water. He's gonna come and eat the fishies. Remember the Guns N' Roses lyric. What's so civil about war anyway? Honestly. Ooh. This has got to be it. It's already red. I don't remember what the Admiral looks like, but it would be so funny if it's just a tiny, 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 tiny little fish. Super strong and difficult to catch, but tiny, tiny. I think this is it. This is a difficult already. As soon as it goes yellowy orange, I let go. Oh, let go of the reel line. Oh God. Have patience. It's all about patience. Yeah, we saw the cannons. That was cool. Yeah, freaking cannons on boats. That's nuts. If you ask me, that's nuts. No. Alright, let go. I just don't want this to be broken like that other job. Oh! I just can never actually pull it out of the water, and then all of a sudden I pulled it out of the water in like a second.
He's getting tired.
Oh, what? It goes red? Oh my God. Well, that was it. Okay. I gotta do this again. Oh no, I see you there. Oh, you're gonna get it. Here you are.
Thanks for the weather report.
Can I just shoot it? There you are. Is that you right there? Someone bite. Get out of here, boat. You're disturbed. No, don't turn this way. Boat! Excuse you.
Wish I could just enjoy the damn day.
Took the words out of my mouth. And put them in your mouth. And spit them into my ears. Doom, 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 doom. Come on, guys. You're both getting to it. Somebody's... There he is.
This is perfect hunting weather.
It is?
Stay focused on what we're doing.
Do I have to wait for it to, like, jump out of the water or something? That's when it gets tired? I don't know. Is this too early to start pulling now? Don't go behind the... Yeah, see, now it's jumping. So now's the time that I pull? Okay, let go. Should I just wait for it to jump out of the water? There we go. Okay, pull. Oh, stop.
I'm gonna fight these bastards the best I know how.
Will that open my eyes?
Let go. Calm down. It's going yellow. Yes!
Holy shit! You caught him!
Yeah.
You actually caught him!
You're goddamn right.
Nice job! Come on back!
Maybe I will.
Prep this.
Keep pulling the joystick down so I don't actually take off. Oh boy.
You
taught me to survive under pressure.
Under pressure.
Come here. Shit! I can't believe it. Folks have been trying to catch the Admiral since, like, before I was born, even. Drubman.
Oh, I didn't know that. I just knew about the muskets filling, just putting all the gunpowder in and
distant memory.
Stuffing it in there.
I'm so happy.
Another reason I didn't know that, why they were just lined up like that. You're just gonna stand there out in the open, putting the gunpowder in, just. Never thank you. Crazy.
Take care of yourself.
I guess just like every generation, we look back like, why were we doing that? That's crazy, because we've improved so much, so we're used to the improvements. We can't admit. What the heck? Yeah, what is happening? That's a great. And you once again took the words out of my mouth. What actually is happening?
Every little bit helps.
I missed it. I missed it again. Did I get the... Did I get my... my one fishing rod? Yay, we have a third one. Beat each region's state records by fishing at hard spots. Well, I did fish at two hard spots. I had to fish at every one of the hard spots? That seemed a little too crazy. We fished at one hard spot here, and that's Faith's region. And we fished at a hard spot here. Jacob's region. I fished for tons of stuff along this river here already. I did tons of fish here. Golden Trout, I've done that. I'll go back and do it again. I definitely got it. I mean, rock bass. Does it show if it was the hard version or not? I guess not. Rainbow, lake trout, bull trout, sturgeon, great albino paddlefish is what I just got. Golden trout. Yeah, I got a golden trout, and I got it from the hard section. I think I've already sold it. Maybe I need to have all of them at the same time.
You hanging in there, hon?
Yes. Do I have the super powerful? No, I don't. I'll try it anyway. I'm already here. There might be a fisherman I can just trade. And of course there's not. And of course there isn't. Golden trout, there it is. Look, it's so tiny. Okay. confused.
Keep walking.
Keep walking. Calm down, lady.
Thank you enough for getting rid.
Beat each region's state records by fishing at hard spots across. What are there? How do you find out the state record? I'm gonna look it up. I know I got this already, so I don't mind looking it up now to kind of speed up the process, because I already did it myself. But I wasn't like actively trying to figure out how to get these things. I was just playing the game naturally, and I guess just as I'm just playing, doing my stuff, I got these things just naturally, exactly. Old, let's see. Oh, okay, there's a board that tells you? You must be all, okay, these records are based on the weight of the fish that were caught. There are 12 of them in total, some of which are specific to a region. Oh, the heaviest of each? Okay. All right. Bull trout, 21 pounds. Okay. Golden trout, 4 pounds. What the heck did I just... What was the weight that I just got? Wow. Oh my god. I definitely got all 4 things. I don't know how I caught that many fish. You're not telling me the weight. You gotta be kidding. How the heck did I do that? Maybe I didn't get it. Now I'm starting to question if I got the last fishing rod. Holy mackerel. Okay. All right, hold on then. Let me make sure that I have my best one. Okay, I didn't. Now I do. Now I'll go back to my menu map. Fast travel right up near to it. And it has to be hard? Maybe it doesn't necessarily have to be the hard spots. You can keep track of records using the 3 boards on the map. There is one. If you look around fishing spots on the map, you'll notice that some are marked as hard. These are the ones you need to be using, as the biggest fish in the game only swim around these spots. Got it. All right. Well, you wanted me to be here longer than an hour. Here I am, fishing. Golden trout, 4 pounds. I gotta do all this fishing to get the top fishing rod, but then what? I've gotten all the best fish. What am I gonna do with the best fishing rod if I've now gotten everything I need to get? But I will get a trophy out of it. So I do get a trophy out of it. That's true. That is true. I wish you could toggle planes and just not have planes when you're fishing. Just have that as an option. Make it even quieter. Why don't they tell you the pounds? Oh, here you go. Get it? I wish they told you the weight of each. I was like, what if I already got a 4-pound one?
That fish has seen better days.
What'd that mean? 409! Got it! Does it say anything about that being the world record for that one? Golden trout. Boom. That's also the golden trout. Bull trout, but not hard. All right, paddlefish sturgeon, let's go. I need to have something more than 55 pounds.
Asia declared his country refused to trade with fools.
And how many fish do I have to do? Oh my, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 of them. Oh my god. Making my own little note. There we go. Golden trout, we got. I can mark it off. Now we're doing palleted sturgeons. Okay. This farm would be a good position for resistance. Hello, little pig. Hello, little piggies. Hello. Discovered, but it was already on my map. Whatever.
Well, hey there. Got a moment?
I see. Okay, there you guys are over there. Even better. I'm on 55 pounds. Maybe having a better rod guarantees better fish. Not just being in the hard locations, but having a better.
Damn beautiful country.
Up person.
Oh yeah. Shame we're shooting at all this shit.
Jesus.
Just the kind of thing to take the food off my mind.
I could use some help here.
They're coming. Get it.
Someone help me out.
A 113. Oh, paddlefish. Oh, that's what I needed. I needed 112, and I got 113.
I can teach you a life lesson if you're interested.
Beautiful.
Come on, little critter. Well, hey there. Got a moment?
I do not have a moment at all. Fish, yes. I said palleted, I meant paddlefish. Alright. Lake trout, I haven't done that. That was right nearby, dang it. So lake trout needs to be 37 pounds. 30, a fish can be 37 pounds? Paddlefish are 112 pounds? Sounds like they're like the size of a shark.
Day like this, Blair can help us.
It must be exhausting being so grim.
We'll come in low out of the rising sun. And then about a mile out, we'll put on the music.
This is my favorite fishing spot.
I like having these two companions with me. They can shoot at the bad guys. They can shoot at the bad guys if someone's coming and an animal or something. But I can focus on fishing.
Clamp down.
Why are you running? Why are you swimming away? This fucking boat. Damn it.
Preppers are solid people. Even the batshit crazy ones.
Do you think so?
Dirty. Dang it. See, this is why I'm glad I got my peoples. Hello? You alright? She was just a little stunned. Pounds heavier, but not enough.
Saw Joseph sit up close once a few years back. What I wouldn't give to go back in time and end this shit right now.
Damn shit, Ray.
Nice catch.
Fuck me.
28. Come on. Oh my god. Are you swimming away? Another boat's coming? Almost.
You're a very up person.
You're cooking on me.
Must
sometimes, I think maybe I don't want this fight to end. Because afterwards, I'm supposed to, what, go back home? Back to normal?
Shit, Grace!
Man. Got the one right away. If I've got the record of the trout, if I go back to that letterboard, will it show my name? If I allow it to struggle more, it'll make the game say, okay, he struggled a long time. We'll make that be the one. 3 pounds under. Difficult. Still wonder if it's just like a timing thing. Like the game will just decide, like, yeah, all right, for this fish, you're gonna have to catch 6 of them before you catch one that's the weight that you need. I truly believe that. They need to do it deliberately, because if it's truly is random, there's a chance of getting it all super easy, right? And they want to make sure that that's not the case. Or it's like there are always 7 fishes running around, and if you have a chance, you have 1 in 7 chance of throwing your line towards the one that's the heaviest. What happens if you fish all 7 of them out? Maybe they keep resetting every time you fish. I'm on the hard one. I am. Lake trout hard. Lake trout 37 pounds can be found everywhere. Maybe I gotta find a different hard area. Maybe there's a better hard area.
You think things are gonna actually get better, or is this just how it is now? One painful day after another.
You don't say.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Bull trout's not even listed. Oh no, there it is. It's up there. All right, I'll try this next then. Is this a bull trout normal? Rainbow trout. I don't have rainbow trout. Okay. I guess we'll do this first then, because I'm super close.
What if there ain't nothing after we die? What if all we got is our memories? And after we're gone, there's nothing.
That's possible. How you guys are gonna get down? I'm the parachute. You guys are gonna have to figure out your own thing. Uh-oh. What's down there? That's red.
Joseph seed up close once a few years back. What I wouldn't give to go back in time and end this shit right then.
Call me when you get the big one. Got something.
Actually get better, or is this just how it is now? One painful day after another.
That fish has seen better days.
Yeah.
You need me? You know how to find me.
sunshine warms me like the glow of Joseph's love.
Just another day in Hope County.
Hey there, Rook.
I can build my own ladder.
Sir, beat classic country music.
This is fantastic. There's new stuff added all the time.
Thanks a million.
Embrace the energy of the animals. You were once them, they were once you.
Yep. Damn, I can build my own levels.
Thank you.
They were once you.
Hey.
Can't thank you enough for getting rid of those fucking cultists.
I could play this game all day.
Thank you. here!
Grasp it. Unless I can't grasp. In which case, I just use my other hand. I'm terrible.
Gotta keep an eye out for Peggy. They come near me, they're as good as dead.
Get all starfoods up and home.
Excellent fishing conditions today. Save a cow, eat a fish. Plenty of fish in the water. Canned food gets tainted. Catch fish instead. For this sport. You got some good forearm strength. Gets tainted. Catch fish instead. You got some good forearm strength. Fish, huh? Excellent fishing conditions today. You need patience for this work. Save a cow, eat a fish.
One on topic and one off topic question, if you will indulge.
Depends on the question.
So on the on topic, based on the allegations of this and some of the other cases that you brought, I'm wondering whether the concern in the industry about the ability of some of these startup companies, some of the smaller companies, to abide by this very costly regulatory and legal regimen that the United States requires, whether it will mean that you can't really do virtual currency and have this industry thrive and some of the cutting edge things that Lisa and Monica just mentioned with that very heavy burden of regulatory compliance. I'm wondering whether you have a message for the industry when it comes to that. And then if I can ask my off-topic question, we're expecting at any moment the Israeli government and some of the other parties to announce an agreement for the release of hostages in being held by Hamas. If you can comment on that, and also just what the Justice Department and some of the other agencies that are represented here are doing to respond to the attacks in Israel on October 7th. We know, obviously, that Hamas has had a presence here in the United States, and the concern about how they raise money, including, of course, by cryptocurrency, is something that is on everyone's mind. I'm wondering what you're doing about that in light of what happened.
All right, let me start with the off-topic. I was in a meeting this morning with national security officials, law enforcement officials, and the president regarding fentanyl, and he told the press that his team has been actively negotiating over possibility of bringing home some of the hostages. They thought that we were very close to being able to do that, but that he couldn't say anything more at that time, and I also can't say anything more at this time. With respect to the deaths of Americans, we always investigate deaths of Americans, and we are actively investigating the deaths of the Americans using all the tools available to us. We have, I think, as the FBI director said at a recent threats hearing before the judiciary, and as I've said, we are investigating Hamas connections in the United States with respect, particularly with respect to financial support, and that includes cryptocurrency, but we are also concerned about the possibility of more kinetic problems that they could cause, and we're investigating that. Now I've talked a lot, so on the on-topic question, I will say, you follow the law. You don't get a special benefit because you think that what you're doing is better for society, or better for small business, or better for big business, or better for international. The United States has laws, and everybody, including cryptocurrency platforms, have to follow the law.
Chad.
No. Dang it. Oh, really? I was listening to the press conference and that was playing through the stuff? Even though... All of this turned off, though. That was playing. Wow. I don't understand why. What on earth? Oh my God.
Topic and one off-topic question, if you will indulge.
I have a lot to fix now. Great. Lovely. Okay, I don't know. This is getting frustrating. I stayed on for a little bit longer, at least. I did. I stayed on for 2 hours. So that's double the length. I've got to figure out what's going on with this audio, and I'm going to be fishing forever, so maybe that's not really a good thing to stream. So I'm going to end it here, but thank you for sticking with me. I'm going to check out all those people. I'm going to actually screen capture what you said of all the different rappers. I'm scrolling up. Yeah, okay. Dan Bull is another legendary nerdcore rapper. Listen to Bring Toonami back. Richard Branson. Okay. I'm screenshotting it, so at least I have that. Lupe Fiasco, yes. Yeah, Kick Push. I didn't even see that you said Lupe Fiasco. I like Kick Push, Kick Push. Here's a bit more stuff. All right. I'm going to figure out this audio situation. I'm going to check out these new rappers. See you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.